Excellency, Mr. Juha Sipilä, Prime Minister of Finland, Honorable Mr. Jussi Pahonen, Mayor of Helsinki, dear Tari Halonen, former President of Finland, Mr. Gwen Lister, founder of the Namibian Executive Chair of the Namibia Media Trust, all partners, supporters of this event, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. After this beautiful, moving performance, and I would like to thank the National Ballet of Finland, indeed, it is time to talk about freedom, press freedom. And I think these days are one of the most inspiring moments on the global calendar. It is a moment to celebrate the freedom of every woman and man to express themselves. And it is also a moment to shine light on the right to access and share information, so important in nowadays globalized world. But it is also a moment to stand with all journalists to defend their safety. I believe freedom of expression goes to the very heart of what it means to be human. We all strive to understand the world. We all seek information and knowledge. We all wish to express opinions and views. This is who we are. This is what we celebrate today. And I can hardly think of a better place for this than Helsinki.
Madam Director General, President Halonen, Mr. Mayor, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to welcome you all to the International World Press Freedom Day in Helsinki. When I look around, I see a record number of participants, an impressive array of media, academia, governmental and civil society representatives. I also know that this event is being followed around the world over the internet. I want to thank you all for the determination, courage and professionalism that you show in defending freedom of expression and freedom of press on all continents every day of the year. Madam Director General, it's a great honor for Finland to co-host this event with UNESCO. This is the first time that the main event is being held in a Nordic country. The celebration of the World Press Freedom Day are also part of Finland's presidency of the Nordic Council of Ministers this year. Hosting this event in 2016 has a very special meaning for us Finns. This year, we together with Sweden are celebrating 250 years of our Freedom of Press Act. Issued in 1766, the initiative of Finnish parliamentarian Sydenius, it was the first ever act on freedom of information in the world.
Madam President, Mr. Prime Minister, esteemed Director General of UNESCO, Madam Irina Bokova, Excellencies, distinguished representatives of the World Press, ladies and gentlemen. I'm profoundly pleased and delighted to welcome the UNESCO World Press Freedom Day Conference to Helsinki. Your timing could not be better or more apt from our point of view. This year, as already been heard, marks the 250th anniversary of the world's first Freedom of Information Act.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's my pleasure and honor to read the lived words of my great friend and colleague Gwen Lister from Namibia. Gwen has entitled her address 25 years after the Windhoek Declaration, Press Freedom, Right to Information and Transparency.
Ilmassa member now. I've been a member for a long time on the board of the Committee to Protect Journalists, and I've worked with them for many, many years. A few years ago, I, as part of another activist committee for journalism, the International IWMF, the International Women's Media Foundation, gave a prize.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to sunny Helsinki. Nice to see you all here. As Mugens told, I'm Hanne Aho. I'm president of Union of Journalists in Finland and moderating this conversation today. And first, we're taking the speeches from the panelists and then questions. So you have, I think you have plenty of time to ask and discuss after these speeches. They say that Finnish people are not so good taking compliments, and that's true. But anyway, we are really proud to say that when we're talking about the Press Freedom Index, we're of course very proud to say that we're the best in the world.
My name is Charlotte Åbo. I'm an editor at the Danish newspaper Information. And I'm here participating in this event to tell about a specific issue of the newspaper that we did in the autumn, where we let refugee journalists who came to Denmark from like Syria, Afghanistan, Thailand and other countries edit and write the newspaper from A to Z. And it was a very great experience for them and for us to meet in a professional way and to assist each other in a professional way. And for some of these journalists, this specific issue of the paper, it has actually been their entrance into Danish media world. And some of them are now working as journalists in Denmark with the Danish mainstream media. And for this, we consider this project a very big success.
Здравствуйте, меня зовут Майкл Рэндл, я работаю на фонд BBC, это как раз тот департамент в BBC, который управляет проектами по развитию средств массовой информации по всему миру. В данный момент я управляю проектом в арабском мире, который направляется на поддержку и на развитие общественного вещания. Мы сотрудничаем с всеми телерадиокомпаниями в регионе и активно продвигаем новые новаторские идеи для молодежи. То есть наш проект основан на восприятии, что в данный момент просто не хватает программ, которые отражают интересы и потребности молодой аудитории. Мы работаем, сотрудничаем с телерадиокомпаниями, чтобы улучшить качество этих программ и чтобы увеличить количество.
My name is Nicholas Nugent. I'm a journalist of long standing. I used to work for the BBC, for BBC News, but now I'm an independent journalist and mainly I train journalists and I attend events like this. Here we're gathering today under the auspices of IREX Europe to discuss the issues of journalism between Ukraine and Russia. As the title of the session says, two countries, one profession. So it's really to mark the fact that despite all the differences between the two countries, journalism is journalism and journalists liaise with each other across the borders. And indeed, the representatives of the unions of journalists in Russia and Ukraine have been meeting regularly over recent months in Vienna to coordinate issues to do with journalists' safety and ethics, basically.